It's time for the match game. Hollywood Squares Hour with the stars of St. Elsewhere, Terence Knox, Ed Begley Jr., Norman Lloyd. The stars of the match game Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bellman.
Welcome. Thank you. Hey, we're both wearing suits.
Great audience.
Yes.
Boy, they're alive.
You're a very lively, terrific group. We're going to put out for you today, aren't we, gang?
What? Great.
Good.
Well.
What was that? What'd you say, Kim? Would you say that again? Oh, thank you very much. Shall we have a go at it? Yes.
Yeah, sure.
Yes. This, as you can plainly see, let me remind you once again, all of this week we are honored to have with us all of these beautiful performers from the big hit NBC show, St. Elsewhere. And here they are. And I must say, for, you know, you would expect straight actors to come out here and be kind of straight. But these people are witty, amusing.
Wait a second.
And,
first we're going to put out, then we're not straight.
Right.
What's going on here?
Yeah. Not a straight one in the bunch, I'll tell you that right now. All right, let's get underway by meeting our two players here, Christine Ladinsky and Elise Rome. I want to hear about you first. Christine, I was just looking at your pendant.
Say that straight.
That looks like a little Scotty dog. No, that's a boot.
It's a cowboy boot.
It's a cowboy boot. Why?
My husband's a cowboy.
Your husband's a cowboy. Okay, that's the end of the interview. No, I'm only kidding. Where do you live, Christine?
I live in Covina.
Yeah.
I was born in Canada. I am married, have a four-year-old little boy named Isaac.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoarse.
Why are you hoarse?
From screaming for the show.
Really?
And I love horseback riding.
And you
outdoors.
Do that often?
Not as as I would like, but I do it.
Okay, Christine, good luck to you.
Thank
Elise, you. Let's hear about you.
Well, I'm a native of Southern California, and I'm a senior at Cal State Fullerton. I have a wide variety of interests. I love to dance, and I love sports, and I'm a member of the first placed fencing team at Cal State Fullerton.
Really? Fencing is a very energetic sport and a wonderful sport. People think, you know, it's for sissies and all that, but it's, boy, when you fence, I used to fence when I was in school too, and it really is, you can work up a great sweat doing that.
Oh, yeah.
All right, here on the match game, we don't ask you to work up a sweat, we just ask you to match as many of the stars as you can, and the one who's done that most often will be the winner. Go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Christine, you won the toss, we'll ask you to go first.
B, please.
All right. B says this. Carl said, that's the last time I go on a picnic with the Fat Family. That's F-A-T-T, Fat Family. He says, I can't believe how much they ate. When they finished the food, they ate the blank. Put it in the slot.
That music does it, you know. It just...
Yeah, that music gets to you. Here we go, Christine. Kyle said that the last time I go on a picnic with the Fat Family, I can't believe how much they ate. When they finished the food, they ate the blank.
The picnic basket?
The picnic basket. Okay. I like that. Now, there are a number of good choices here. Picnic basket was one of them, Norman.
Well, I don't think it's a picnic without ants.
They ate the ants. Very good. All right. So far, we've had two good answers, one from our contestant and one from Norman.
And now here's a third good answer.
Another good answer.
The plate.
The paper plate, right? Another good one. Kim?
Paper plate.
So we have two paper plates. One picnic basket. What do you got for us?
I got another gaggle of ants.
All right.
I'm sorry.
They ate the ants. Right?
They didn't. They ate the picnic basket.
Picnic basket. All right.
I know this family, the Fat family.
Oh, you're familiar with them?
The Wide Load family, otherwise known as.
Wide Load.
And they get an elevator. It better be going down. And I said picnic basket.
All right. So, she picks up two in her first round question. Pretty good, I think. Now let's see what we have for you, Elise. Unlucky Louie said, I open an account at First Surgeons National Bank. First Surgeons National Bank. I opened the account so I could get the free gift. Just my luck, they gave me a blank. You can copy on anyone from St. Elsewhere.
I'm medically inclined.
I just can't spell anything.
Well, I'll help you with spelling. If you're...
Or...
Great.
All right.
No, it's the other way. It's all right.
It's up to you.
Man, I can look bad.
Here we go, Elise. Unlucky Louie said, I just opened an account at First Surgeons National Bank so I could get the free gift. And just my luck, they gave me a blank.
Surgical mask.
A surgical mask. See, Elise, they're booing because it wouldn't be so bad if they gave you a surgical mask, because if you were out here in the smog, you could use it and put it to good use. We're looking for something that he really didn't want, and he would not want a surgical mask that badly, right?
Right. Well, you know, Gene, you and I were talking before about the old days in the theater, so I've been an actor a long time.
Yes, sir.
And I'm used to taking a cut.
Aha! Right. Now, wait, has two meanings there, you know, a cut in salary or a cut with a scalpel. That's not bad there, Norman. Terence?
Well, I don't know if the spelling is right here, but scalpel.
Scalpel. Isn't that the correct spelling?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's a correct.
Doesn't match,
a little
though.
Collaboration on the spelling there.
Nice boo, you know. Be there for me.
He gave him a tonsillectomy. NBC.
Tonsillectomy. All right. Just my luck, they gave me a...
This is something you really wouldn't want under normal circumstances, Gene. An enema.
Okay.
Popular answer.
All
great
right.
Play, an enema of the people.
Right.
Okay, the surgeons gave him an operation.
An operation. Elise is looking for a surgical mask.
I'm sorry, I matched someone else. I said scalpel.
A scalpel. All right. So we had a couple of scalpels and some other things. So there at the end of round one, it's 2-0 in Christine's favor. Round two right after this. Here we go with round two. Christine, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
B, please.
B?
Mm-hmm.
You got it. Hey. The dentist said to George Washington, he says, I have good news and bad news about your wooden teeth. The good news is you don't have a single cavity. The bad news is you have blank.
I mean, obviously, right?
Yeah, obviously.
Just for fun.
That's right.
Hey.
All right, Kim's ready.
I'm ready.
Norman's ready.
I'm going to win a lot of money today.
All right. Christine, the dentist said to George Washington, I have good news and bad news. The good news is, he said good about your wooden teeth. The good news is you don't have a single cavity. The bad news is you have blank.
Termites.
They like that one,
yes.
Don't they?
They did like that, but as you know, Gene, George Washington yes. always told the truth.
Right.
And it was, I happen to know, a woodpecker.
You're getting ugly.
You're honest.
Yesterday, he understood the question so clearly. I think you misunderstood that one, Norman.
They're wooden teeth.
They're wooden teeth. Oh, yeah. The woodpecker was working on them.
Working.
Oh, I see. Doing a little orthodonture.
Yeah.
Go sit in the car, Norman.
What have you got?
Splinters.
Splinters.
That's pretty good.
Yes. Termite was wonderful. Splinters is good.
I didn't see how the termites could get, stay in the mouth and all that, but I said termites.
You said it anyway. All right. So you're up to three, Christine, and now you have one more shot at it with John.
Well, as many of you know, if you've watched this show before, my father was a dentist. Therefore, I said termites.
All right. Ready?
All right. Dr. Bauman.
Bertha and Herb are speaking. Bertha said to Herb, she said, I'm so upset I'm going to a head shrinker. She talks that way, funny like that. She says, I'm going to a head shrinker. And Herb said to Bertha, it ain't your head that needs shrinking, it's your blank.
Can't say it.
Who said to him? Who finally said what to whom?
Herb said to Bertha, it ain't your head that needs shrinking, it's your blank.
Gotcha.
We have great answers.
Great answers.
Here we go. Bertha said to Herb, I'm so upset I'm going to a head shrinker. And Herb said to Bertha, it ain't your head that needs shrinking, it's your blank.
Your waistline.
Your waistline. All right.
Tough crowd.
Yeah, that...
Now you know, Gene, this is a very dangerous question.
Yes, it is.
Because it involves the women in
right.
a certain way. You know what I mean.
I know exactly what you mean.
But I'm only fulfilling this as, as a script, so to speak.
Right.
So
right.
I say mouth.
Mouth is good. Yeah, in other words, he was saying, you got a big mouth, Bertha.
I said mouth, too.
Two mouths. She's looking for waistline, Kim.
Well, most women think they need to shrink their rear ends.
But not Kim. Kim is the perfect person. What have you got for us?
So are you, Gene.
Thank you.
Well, if you were watching the show just a minute ago, you might know that my father was a dentist. So you might have assumed that I would say mouth. However, I said derriere.
Oh.
With an accent grave.
All right, Elise is looking for an answer which is unlikely to come up here. Waistline, what have we got from you?
I'm sorry, I said rear.
You said rear? And you, sir?
Mouth.
Mouth. All right, so the front end and the rear end there were in... Now, listen, it's 4-0 now. You got a little catching up to do. You got one more shot at it. Third and final round after this. Here we go. Third and final round.
Yeah, that's true.
Christine, you're still ahead. You're number one here. What would you like to do, A or B?
B again, please.
All right. You've had B every time? All right, let's see what happens. Two people play. Norman and Terence, please respond to this. The Godfather said,
some of my boys carry a switchblade knife. Not dumb Donald. He's so dumb. He carries a switchblade blank.
Just the two of us.
Yes.
I can't copy off nobody else's paper because I'm not writing.
Oh, well, she'll write one down and give it to you.
Yeah.
What's the question?
Yeah.
I was an English major. I can't spell.
Yeah. Okay. Calm down.
Brett, Christine. Godfather said, some of my boys carry a switchblade knife, not dumb Donald. He's so dumb he carries a switchblade blank.
The only thing I can think of is spoon.
Spoon! That's okay. Knife.
She could have read that question very well.
Right, with her voice.
With her voice.
Well, now, Gene, we're talking about stupidity, aren't we?
We are. That's right. Really dumb.
Good, nice.
How dumb was he, Norman?
That's what I mean. You know, it gives us such a vast range.
Yes, it does.
Too many choices.
Right.
So I found it difficult. I said toothbrush.
Switchblade toothbrush. You're right. Give him a good one, right from the heart.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes. Norman, you needed that.
Yes.
All right, Terence.
Now, I'm vulnerable and sensitive today. I want you guys to be easy with this. Calm.
Calm.
This answer.
I have one of those.
It really was rotten. They're just complying with your request there. No, switchblade, knife, fork, and all of that stuff, and spoon would have been okay, and we'll see. Now, Elise, you need 4 to tie and 5 to win. Either possibility could happen. At the beach, Dumb Dora said, I never have to worry about my top falling off. That's because I blanked it on.
She's dumb, right? Dumb Dora.
Yes. Remember, this is Dumb Dora. She never has to worry about her top falling off because she blanked it on.
Well, do you think that, or do you think...
That was my first choice.
That is lousy. That's a lousy.
Right. Oh, grow up.
Here we go. Elise. At the beach, Dumb Dora said, I never have to worry about my top falling off, and that's because I blanked it on.
Glued.
Glued. Good.
Glued.
Glued is good.
Well, now, Gene, what I'm about to say is actually from experience. I've seen this.
You have?
I have seen it.
Where do you go?
Painted.
Painted. That's very good.
Thank you.
Excellent.
See, the trouble with the glue, it's like a stamp. If you lick it more than once, it comes off. So I put painted.
Painted. All right. Glue.
I hope this helps a little. I
got to match them all now. Glued. All right. 4-1 the score. You need 3 more glues for a tie here. John.
I guess I just must be into pain, Gene. Stapled.
Staple it on. All right, that means Christine wins the game. What a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Gonna send some gifts here for the match game. Elise Rome, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Hey, congratulations. Now we're gonna switch to Hollywood Squares. Here comes the rest of our set. 3 more stars will appear here. John and I will trade places, and we've got lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar stylish video cassette recorder that combines the convenience of front loading with the performance of a true track forehead system furnished by Quasar. And now it's time for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares with more of the stars of St. Elsewhere, Nancy Stafford. Eric Laneuville. Taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
Okay, we're going to operate in just a couple of minutes. Don't miss it. It'll be a first.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Welcome, everybody, to the Hollywood Squares portion of our show. And welcome once again to Christine Ladinsky, who is a horsewoman, who is also a horsewoman. But she had enough voice to get herself through the match game, and that's all that counts. She will move on to Hollywood Squares. 3 brand new celebrities: Howie Mandel, Eric Laneuville, and Nancy Stafford.
Oh, hey, nice.
All, of course, stars of St. Elsewhere. Hi, Howie.
How you doing?
Fine, thanks. Huh?
It's good to be here. I'm excited about being here. It's changing my life. It is. I've been here for 2 days now. I went home at the end of each day, but I've been... In fact, it's affecting me so much that I went home last night and I blanked. For like 2 hours.
Well, let's hope that doesn't happen to you during Hollywood Squares, Christine. Here we go. And before we begin the game, we're going to say hello to our defending champion once again. His name is George Strine. He had a pretty nice day yesterday. He did not blank. He came away with $21,725. And I can see he's still enthusiastic.
Got to be.
Why don't you remind us a little bit about your life to date?
I live in Santa Barbara. I'm a freelance writer and a professional bodyguard.
We'll be very careful here, and we will play Hollywood Squares until you hear the time up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point wins. That's logical. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. You won 20 yesterday. Not bad start. Our first game is worth $100, $25 for every square. George, you're our champ. Pick a star and let's go.
Terence, please.
I'm in the center square, man. They put the sharpest, quickest guy, right?
Wait till tomorrow.
I'm ready.
Terence,
yeah.
Your St. Bernard has been drinking again.
Yeah.
Is it bad for him to use Visine? Or can he use it to get the red out?
He should not use Visine, man. Are you crazy or something?
He says your dog shouldn't use Visine. Agree or disagree for the first square, George?
I'll agree.
It is okay for a dog to use Visine. No, you shouldn't disagree with the sharpest guy in the center square. And your opponent starts off with the first square. That is useful information. All right, Christine, it's your move. You're playing O.
Howie, please.
Howie Mandel.
All right.
How can you make your bathroom smell sweeter, Howie?
Don't use it.
There are only two choices here, though, according to Mary Ellen. Should you dab perfume on your light bulb?
Oh, man.
Or should you put tea bags in your toilet tank?
I would, honestly, it is putting tea bags in your toilet tank. That helps it make it smell better, and you always have refreshments for when the company's in. They say, any more tea? You say, sorry, I just flushed. Tea bags.
Christine, he says, you should put tea bags in your toilet tank. Agree or disagree?
I'll
to make
agree.
Your bathroom smell sweeter. We're a long way from this question.
I'll
you agree?
Agree?
You should dab perfume on your light bulb. No, you should have disagreed with Howie.
I put
and
coffee.
Your opponent gets that square and evens up the game. So we got an X and an O up there. $25 to $25. George, your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Ready.
Your doctor has just X-rayed the hardest thing in your body.
Ha, ha, ha. Yeah. Okay. Next, doctor.
Is it your thigh bone or your teeth?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Well, with advancing years, you get osteoporosis and the bones become harder and more brittle.
Don't they, doctors?
And yes, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. I have my backup research team here with me. However, the teeth are much harder than the bones ever get at their hardest stage.
So he says the teeth are the hardest thing in your body. Agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
Your teeth are the hardest thing in your body. All right, good going. You're right to agree. You get the square, and you got a couple of X's up there. 1-0 for you, Christine, but it is your move.
Norman to block.
Norman Lloyd to block. She misses this one. The first game belongs to George. Norman, you had your tonsils out 10 years ago. Is it likely that your doctor would do the same thing today? Or was it probably unnecessary?
Probably unnecessary.
I agree.
For a block, it was probably unnecessary. You were right to agree.
Absolutely.
You get the square and you do block. Well done.
Right.
Unfortunately, you can't
put
it back. But we're going to be back to finish this $100 game right after these messages come back with us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
50-50. We got a tight one. George, it's your move.
Kim to block, please.
You missed this one. Christine, the challenger, takes the first game. Kim Miyori, your parrot is getting on in years. Your parrot is getting on in years. And he's not moving as fast as he used to. Now, is it possible that he is getting bird arthritis? Or is there no such thing?
I feel so bad for my bird. I would say, yeah, it would be possible. He could get bird arthritis.
Thank you, Doctor. Agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
It is possible that he's getting bird arthritis. Well done, Kim and George. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. So, it's a complicated board in the first game. Christine, where would you like to put an O?
Ellen, please. Mm-hmm.
Man, I'm sitting in the center square, and there's still no one.
You're done, Terence.
Look at that.
Einstein. Wait till next game. Ellen Bree.
Yes. Yes.
You ask a guy for a date, Ellen. According to Cosmo, is it up to you to make the first romantic move, or should you let him do it so you won't seem too pushy?
Would you repeat that?
Sure.
Yeah.
You ask a guy for a date. You ask him out. According to Cosmo, is it okay for you to make the first romantic move, or should you just let him do it so you won't seem too pushy?
Get it.
Well, knowing Cosmo, I'd say it would be okay for you to make the first move. Of course, you already did make the first move. You asked him out.
This is the second romantic move.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's the second move. First romantic move.
You could probably make a couple moves.
Well, agree or disagree, Christine?
I'd agree.
You should let him do it, according to Cosmo. It's according to Cosmo. I know. Okay,
well,
you should have disagreed with
that. What if he has?
What if he has bird arthritis?
George, pick a star.
Ed to win, please.
This could win you the game. Ed Begley Jr., it is Saturday afternoon and you're bored. Just for fun, you get all the people in the United States together and you try to seat them in all the cars in this country. Will they all get a seat, or will there be some people left standing?
Boy, this is a tough. Is this all the cars on the road, or is this I assume they mean all the cars on the road, not cars in the junkyard.
Yeah,
that would be a pretty safe
assumption.
Okay.
Right. None of the cars have arthritis.
Repeat it one more time, John.
Oh, no! You're bored. You get all the people in the United States together, you try to put them in all the cars in the country. Will they all get a seat, or will there be some people left standing?
They'll all get a seat.
Agree or disagree for the game, George?
I'll agree.
They will all get a seat. Very well done. Seats than there are people. Okay, congratulations, George. 225 to 50. Quickly clear the X's and O's off the board because we're going to move on to a $200 game. $25 for every square. Christine, your move.
Terence, please.
Terence, you brought home a load of dried garbanzo beans.
I love garbanzo beans, actually.
Before you boil your beans, should you soak them in water, or is that unnecessary?
You flush them. You have to soak them.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I agree.
You should soak your garbanzo. Yes, you've come to the right square, and you get it. An O goes up there.
Chickpeas.
George,
yes.
Pick a star.
Nancy, please.
Nancy Stafford.
Good, I get to play. Okay.
Although it cannot be seen by the naked eye, your body actually lights up when you do this. Is it when you drink alcohol or when you get an idea?
Ding! An idea!
Agree or disagree, George?
Trust me, George.
I'll agree.
Your body actually lights up when you drink alcohol. No, you should have disagreed with Nancy Stafford, who got her chance to play. You can see this under a microscope only. No need to feel self-conscious in your favorite bar. Christine? You've got a leg up on this game. Pick a star for an O.
Gene, please.
Mr. Rayburn, for a game win, you're adding garbage, grass, and dead guppies to your compost heap.
Oh, man.
Should you pack it all in tightly, or is it best to toss your compost just like a salad?
Well, I have experience in this. I do have a compost heap in my house in Cape Cod. And the idea is to keep it loose and let the air pass through it. You shouldn't pack it tightly.
So you should toss it like a salad.
Right.
For the game, agree or disagree, Christine?
I agree.
You should toss your compost heap just right. Like a salad.
Yes, right. Your heap needs air. Gene knows his compost heaps. Your heap needs air. It's perfect. Okay, congratulations. You were ahead, 325. Christine, 225 for you, George. But there's plenty of time left. We're going to find out what happens in a $300 game after this. The $21,000 man may be on the ropes. We will find out with a $300 game, which you get to start, George.
Terence, please.
Terence Knox.
Yeah.
Who would win in a foot race, Terence? An average anteater or an average ant?
Hey, the anteater.
I'll agree.
The anteater would win in the foot race, yes. You're right to agree, you get the square. I guess that means the ant would really lose. Christine, your move, place an O.
Gene, please.
Gene Raber.
Ready.
Okay. Pope John Paul II is taking lessons in this to prepare for an upcoming trip. Is he learning to speak Korean or is he learning to ski?
Speaking Korean or learning to ski? He's going to the Orient, and I guess Korea is on his itinerary, and he's learning to speak Korean.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I'll agree.
He is learning to speak Korean.
Right.
Right to agree. You get this. I think he already knows how to ski very well. Isn't he an expert skier?
Yeah.
Hope he's going to Korea. George, your move.
Norman, please.
Norman Lloyd.
Sir.
According to the 1949 edition of Esquire's Handbook for Hosts, at a dinner party, you should put something at each guest's place at the table. Is it cigarettes or Rolaids?
Well, I just want to say by way of preface, I would put neither. But for purposes of the question, mm-hmm. I would say cigarettes.
He says cigarettes at that 1949 edition of Esquire's dinner party.
I'll agree.
It is cigarettes. You are right to agree. 1949, I guess, is the operative phrase there. You get the square.
That was good.
Okay.
I always put the check.
Well done. Christine, your move.
Kim to block.
You missed this one, the game, and the lead goes back to George. Kim, what's the first thing you should do for a bad sunburn? Should you soak in a cool bath or rub your body with animal fat?
Animal fat. Ooh.
Ooh, that could be interesting.
Ooh.
I would say you want to take the heat away. I would say you would want to soak in a cold tub.
Agree or disagree, Christine?
I agree.
You would want to soak in a cool bath. Yes. Right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. So, it's still as close as it's been the whole day. George, make
Ed,
your move.
Please.
Ed Begley Jr., for an X. Ed, when a skunk spreads his odor, does he aim, or does he just squirt that stuff all over the place?
He aims very carefully. Yes, he aims.
Ed aims. Yeah, the skunk aims. Agree or disagree, George?
I'll agree.
He aims. You're right to agree. You get the square. Well done. So, where would you like to place an O?
Howie to block.
Once again, same position. George could take the game if you miss. Howie Mandel, you've got a bad back and an old lumpy mattress. According to the back book, should you throw a couple of blankets on the floor and sleep there? Or would you be better off in a hammock?
Would I be better off in a hammock? No, I think you need the support, so I would go on the floor and take a couple of blankets and throw them on the floor to give you the hard support. Or you're sleep in the bathroom. It smells great in there.
Agree or disagree, you should sleep on the floor, Christine.
I knew he was going to say so. I didn't know what he was going to
say. Hold on, this is for the game. For a block, rather.
I'll agree.
You should sleep on the floor. Yes. Right to agree. Get the square and you do block. Might as well have been for the game. The board is filling up, George.
Eric,
would you like
please.
To put an X? Eric Laneuville. Eric, you crack an egg, and the white has a greenish tinge.
Is it okay to eat it, or should you call the paramedics first?
This is something I happen to know a lot about.
Throw it away.
Trust me, George. Eat it.
George, Eric says eat it.
I'll agree.
It is okay to eat it. Yes, you're right to agree. It's okay to eat that egg with the greenish tint and then call the paramedics. Nope. Well done. You got an X there. Where would you like to place it, Christine?
Ellen to block.
Once again, you missed this one. The game and the lead belongs to George.
Oh,
Ellen
no.
Bree,
okay.
The Consumer Federation of America says that this is the most hazardous thing in your garage. Is it your car or your lawnmower?
In the garage?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely the car. I mean, I've never heard of anyone really getting chopped up by a lawnmower in the garage, and people die of carbon monoxide poisoning when they...
She says it's the car. Agree or disagree, Christine? The car is the most hazardous thing in your garage.
I'll agree.
It is your car. You are right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. There is the bell. It means the time is up. The last question was pivotal. $425. New champ, Christine Leninsky. Congratulations, Christine.
Thank you.
You have done it. Run right over there. Join Gene Rayburn for your shot at the big money. Wait 1 second. Much better. Oh, boy. Well, that was one of the tightest contests ever. It was about to come down. It always comes down to one question. It really was, came down to that last question, which she got. Had she missed it, the game would have been yours, and you would have been here another day. But you had a nice day yesterday.
Certainly did.
He's leaving $22,050 for George Stride.
Thank you very
much.
Good
going.
Thank you.
Gene, take it away.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ, Christine, and the nine celebrities will be back for a go at the $30,000 right after this.
The super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Here we go. Well, Christine, it's time for the super match. You know, in this portion of the game, you could win up to $30,000. You ready for it?
Yeah, I sure am.
Your voice holding out?
Uh-huh.
All right. We'll read your lips in case you run out of voice. No problem.
It's good enough.
Here we go. We polled an audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Love, blank. If you give us the answer that they chose most frequently, it's $1,000. For the second one, $500. And for the third one, $250. Now, any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here. Call on them, if you will, please, one at a time.
Ellen, please.
She saw my eyes. Lovesick.
Lovesick is one.
Howie.
Affair.
What's that?
Affair.
Love affair.
Affair.
Okay. All right.
Love affair.
Just didn't hear you, that's all.
Love.
You don't have to get hostile
affair.
About it.
Affair. I'm not. It's okay. Affair.
All right.
And John.
Love letters.
All right. So you have love letters, love affair, and lovesick. Now it's time for you to make a decision to choose one of those or perhaps think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll go with lovesick.
Good.
Lovesick. That's the one that Ellen gave you. Let's find out if lovesick is up there. And if it is there, where is it? That's the question. Is it under the $250 response? Yes, it is. Well.
Oh, that's what it.
He's got $250. Now, hold on here.
Oh.
What do you think's under the next one, stars?
We just figured
boat.
It out. Boat is up there. That's
love
the one
boat.
We missed. Boat is the one
that's
we missed.
Boat.
What's under the 500 one slided, Steve?
Yes. Letters.
Love thy neighbor.
What?
Thanks a bunch.
I think you're going to be right. Love boat should
boat,
be on top.
Boat,
right,
boat.
Audience?
Yeah. Yeah.
Slide it, Steve. It is love boat. Well, listen.
Well, at least we got up there.
You've got $250, and now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after that star has been chosen by you, the star will reveal the hidden number. It'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30, and we'll multiply your $250 by that number that's revealed. All right, now, time now to choose a star.
Ed.
All right, Ed, would you grab the tab and give it a yank?
Okay, here we
Ready,
go.
Ready, set, go. 20 times 250 is $5,000. That's what you're playing for. Good luck to you. 5,000 is the sum she's playing for. Here it is. Ice blank. That's I-C-E blank. Ice blank. Put it in the slot when you're finished, Ed. Gosh, he made up his mind very quickly. Christine, it's up to you to collect the $5,000 by matching him. What do you say?
Icicle? I don't know if I can say that.
Icicle? Yeah, that's the first thing that came to your head?
Yeah.
All right. She says icicle, Ed.
Something
what do you
cold,
say?
Cold, but ice cream.
Ice cream, yes. Didn't think of that at all. Oh, gosh, I'm sorry about that. Well, listen, it hasn't been a total loss for you, Christine, because you do have $675. You're still a champ. You get another go at it tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
All right. We'll be back with Christine, our current champ, and our nine stars right after this. Now, let's find out which of the stars had the big number. All right, stars, ready, set, go.
I always love to yank my own thing.
Terence had it.
Terence.
What do I win?
Okay, I remind all of you who are watching us today that all of these people on this stage at this moment, except John and Christine and Jean, are members of the cast of St. Elsewhere, a wonderful show which we heartily recommend for your viewing. So take a look at it. Thank you, stars. You were terrific, and we'll see all of you mañana, okay?
Thank you.
Gene Rayburn here, inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares era. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Vitamix stainless steel pre-minute bread maker and home yogurt factory. A juices without waste, cooks without burning, freezes instant ice cream, and over 800 other recipes. This is Johnny Olson speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.